I am Lizzie with Long Distance Gamers. We're a group of friends who play games remotely due to living in different states. Today I am talking about Nirshima Hex with its expansions Beast. What do I think about this expansion? I won't be going over how to play Nirshima Hex. I will be coming out with a video on how to play that remotely and what I think about the game overall. You could also check out how I feel about all the other armies, as I have done a ranking before Beasts came out of ranking of all the armies. So let's go ahead and get started on what I think about this expansion. So this is what you get in the box. You get, of course, the player mat, as well as a ton of different tiles. You do, of course, get a few of the nets and the bullets, which I just put in my general supply. A few of the differences with this is your headquarters. It starts out with an initiative value of 1, so it goes off a little bit sooner. And then also this symbol means that it is attached to its bodyguard, the Cerberus. Another new difference with this is this melee attack means that it's a melee attack, but it can either attack a friendly or an enemy. And it could attack your headquarters or an enemy's headquarters or just a unit in general. Of course, the defense and movement is still the same, so at least you can move this guy if he gets into an awkward position. However, because the headquarters and its bodyguard are attached, if they move away, then this guy is separated. So if this was your board and he was here and you moved him here, then he would instantly be taken away because he is not immediately next to the headquarters. And then we have this Alpha, which I like him. He does have the attack that attacks friendly as well, but he can be rotated any direction once per turn. And he has an attack of 4. Getting him out and close to your headquarters prevents a lot of damage that could occur. And then another new thing we have is what's called agony. So what agony means is this guy will attack in these 3 directions once he is killed. He gets one final little lash out and he gets to achieve some damage. This will be attacking both friendly and unfriendly. That only occurs though if it would occur during an actual fight. So in battle, if he is killed, then he would go ahead and attack back. However, if you do have the grenade that Burgo throws, and it's if it would attack this, then it wouldn't cause that agony to exist. If it goes off on 1, it would go ahead and do its attack. If it has an agony at 1, it would only do the attack once. However, if it would get enough damage to kill it at 0, then it would do the agony as well. This could also cause a chain reaction, as say this gets hit out of 3 and it attacks something else down here that has an agony that attacks over here. Can go on further and further. This vulture is really cool. It's flying, so melee attacks do not hit it unless this guy is netted. If he's netted, he's, you know, pulled in and he's prevented from being able to fly. But also, once the battle is over, he gets to fly anywhere on the board. So he could be over here, and say the other headquarters is right here, he can move all the way over, assuming that that is an open space. We also have the Arachnid, which this is a net for friendly and unfriendly. So it would be netting any unit on those 3 sides. Doesn't matter if it's yours or your enemies, it's netted. Then we have this one, which this is kind of reminds me of the Dancer ability with being able to attack on a side, but this also includes a move. Now, both of these are optional. So you could choose to just attack or just move, but you cannot change the order. So you have to move and then attack. And this is grab. At first I thought this was a double push, but nah, this is a grab. So what happens is, so say this is an enemy unit and you're choosing to grab with this. He is 1 space away and you can go ahead and pull him towards you. Then whoever owns that unit may choose to rotate it in any way they please. And then the last thing is the Scrambler, which this literally just adds grab to whoever it has. So once per turn, if you had this, then you could pull as well, just as if you had pulled this tile out. This also can rotate once per turn, making it so that you could choose to instead have a unit right here grab in. So that is all the unique tiles and mechanisms specifically to Beasts. So what do I think about it? It is a melee-based army, so you can get into situations where you cannot attack the enemy headquarters simply because you cannot reach. While you do have a couple units that are ranged, it's not the majority of your army. You also have to be very careful because you can attack your own. So with this, you can attack your own or your enemy. So you have to be very careful on how you place it. So you have to be able to plan ahead. You wouldn't want to do that. You would want to do something like that. I do really like the Agony ability. Simply because being able to go off on 2 and then on 0 or 1 is really kind of cool. As well as it just, as it's dying out, it just does one final lash. I find that very thematic and very cool. If you already love and own Neoshima Hex, you're going to get this army regardless of watching this video. If you're just starting out in the Neoshima Hex world, this is kind of a next step army. What I mean by that is you have your basic 4 in the box. And then there's some of the armies like Smart and New York and Iron Gang that are around the same level as those. This, I would say, is a little bit more advanced than that. So if you have played those base armies and a couple others and are looking for something that provides a little bit more depth to it, then this is definitely an army for you. With that said, I do give it a very solid 9.5 out of 10. And if you have watched my ranking of all of the army video and are curious as to where this fits in, this is actually my new number 3. So it goes Smart, New York, Beasts, then Mississippi for me, and so on and so forth. But until next time, just remember to have fun, be present, and be you. Thank you all for watching. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to reach out to us. We would love to hear from you. Also, if you find value in our content, please like, comment, or subscribe. Let a friend or family member know that we exist. Help us spread our channel and bring remote gaming to a table near you. Thank you very much, and have a great day.